Good morning from beautiful Ralston Arena in Omaha, Nebraska, where it's day three of the final of the 2015 International WFTDA D1 tournaments. This tournament, I hate to rate the tournaments against each other, but I like this one's chances if we do. This has been an exciting tournament.
This has been a really, really good tournament. We've had a lot of really good teams, a lot of really good games. It's always exciting to get to see Gotham play.
Yeah.
And it's exciting to see teams that are on their way up and making some fantastic progress.
Right. And there have been some really climbing up the ladder here and making some progress this year, continuing their trajectory from past years. But first, let's talk about the first game of the day, Megatron. I'm denouncer Dwayne Cunningham, by the way. This is Megatron. The first game of the day today is going to feature Windy City taking on Toronto. Now, the path to this game has been something.
A little sad for Toronto in that they are missing a lot of players that would normally be here under standard circumstances. Mm-hmm. And so unfortunate for them and unfortunate for Windy that they have dropped from the number five seed and now they're fighting for ninth.
Both teams now fighting for a seed that is lower than what they came in to the tournament with.
Yeah.
But, you know, a lot has been made of how this is kind of a transitional year for Windy City. And I mean, that's to state the obvious. You know?
Right. And like we were saying yesterday, it's unfortunate to see a team that we're so used to being such a powerhouse, right? Like Windy City for 12 years.
A
powerhouse in the WFTDA. And so for them to have a rebuilding year is a little unfortunate, but it's going to be fun to watch them rise back up.
And it's not the first old school staple WFTDA team we've seen this with. And we've seen plenty of others reinvent themselves, build their way back up. I mean, you know, Minnesota spent years out of the championships,
right,
you know.
Right.
Kansas City isn't, you know, they're in D2 this year.
Right.
It's going to be a good game. Windy versus Toronto coming up next. After that, Helsinki and Queen is going to be a good one.
Yes.
Queen City building their way up. You know, they were competed in D2 the last couple of years. They came in ninth the year before last. They came in fifth in their D2 tournament last year, made their D1 debut, and now they're looking for a seventh place finish. Yeah. I had to count backwards and reverse engineer.
It's always fun to have the international teams, not just from Canada, but from Europe, with the Finnish team of Helsinki, and it's been fun watching them play.
Everybody's loved Helsinki this weekend. They're potentially darlings of this tournament. Although I think that title would have some stiff competition from one of the teams in the next game, and that would be Helsinki's the team that traveled furthest to be here.
Right.
The team that traveled the least amount of distance to be here is No Coast, and they had a tough game with a dramatic ending to begin the entire tournament, but they fought their way back and now they're going for the fifth place finish.
Yeah.
And it's been a beautiful journey throughout the weekend to be here.
Yeah, they started in the number 10 seed. They're fighting for fifth, but they're going to have to compete against Boston. And,
right.
As you guys know, giant Boston fan, I think that's going to be a really fantastic game, seeing both of those teams compete this year. And for Boston, win or lose, this is going to be a step up for them because they've been consistently coming in seventh the past couple of tournaments.
Right.
So it'll be nice to see them move up a spot. They've got a really fantastic lineup. They've got Flying King back after the spleen rupture, so putting up some impressive jamming points.
Yeah, and they were amazing yesterday. Flying King came in and didn't really jam that much and yet put up major points on every jam they did participate in. So really phenomenal jammer on their hands with Flying King. And I don't mean to take away from the other jammers on that squad either. There's some amazing things going on with Boston, and they're continuing to climb up. And it's going to be great to see where they go next year. But as good as that game is going to be, as good as No Coast in Boston is going to be, and it will be a doozy, it's the third place game between Minnesota and Montreal, both looking for a trip to Minnesota, so to speak. One of them lives there.
Right. I think that we were talking about this yesterday. I think that either way, with either of those teams going to St. Paul, it's going to be a fantastic championship tournament with them there. Montreal looks amazing right now.
Yeah.
Even despite the low points performance that they had against Gotham yesterday, they held Gotham to about 250 points, which is impressive in today's Derby.
Yeah, and then Minnesota playing with such heart. They got so many fans here. Their defense was unbelievable last night. It was just a fire wagon of a game last night. And it's going to be, again, do not miss the third place game between Minnesota and Montreal.
Sure.
Going to be ground shaking here in Omaha. And then, of course, the final today, exactly what everybody expected it to be.
Yep.
Gotham versus Angel. Angel is the underdog. You don't say that very often. You do say it today. But we'll see. They might be able to take a pretty big piece out of Gotham, and you just never know.
That's going to be a great game. I think that Angel City has a lot going for them, but Gotham is riding that undefeated wave.
Yeah.
And there's
Gotham looks even better this year than they have in the last few years. Yep.
Especially with their strengthened jammer core.
Yes.
So.
Yep, no doubt about it.
But all right, we've got about a minute and a half to go, so shall we turn it up to the booth?
Yep, we're going to throw it up there. Thanks very much. Enjoy the last tournament day.
It's going to be good.
Good morning, everybody. John Madden here with Mr. Whistler.
Good morning.
And it is the final day, as we've just talked about, the final day of the final Division I tournament. We have 11 teams we've decided upon who are going to St. Paul, and one of whom that might be going to St. Paul is already based there.
Yes.
But we have
Exactly.
We have an entire day of fun and frivolity coming up. These are the seeding. These are the final placement games. This game is for 9th and 10th place. Not exactly where either of these teams really wanted to be, but they don't want to go home last.
No, and so that's where they are. We are going to have Windy City Rollers, Windy City All-Stars, coming from Chicago, Illinois. They are currently ranked number 20 in the WFTDA, came in as the fifth seed, taking on Toronto Roller Derby CN Power from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Toronto, the eighth seed of this tournament, currently ranked number 32 in the WFTDA. Toronto will be wearing white, Windy will be wearing black, and we'll try to do a roster run through at the next time out.
All right, first up for Toronto on the Fast Girl start line, we have Ballerina Reina, number 905 for Toronto, up against Mia Go Ham, number 17. Mia Go Ham, first game of the weekend, did a fantastic, and last night was just totally stymied all night. Had some trouble, but that's why they're in the ninth, tenth game. Unfortunately, for both these teams, both strong teams, we are off. And Mia Go Ham showing what she is used to being, lead jammer straight out of the box. Ballerina makes her way through. I take that back. That was a star pass to the pivot, Rennie Rumble for Toronto. As Mia Go Ham goes through, gets 4 points, and calls it off before Toronto is able to score.
Yeah, Rennie Rumble, no stranger to taking those star passes. We may be seeing that with some frequency this morning here. Quick run through of the Toronto roster. Number 101, Misery Maine. 1205 is Rennie Rumble. Number 18, Anyeka Igwe. 212, Lady Gaga. 213, Sleeper Hole. 22, Mia Culprit. 25, Lexicon. 26, Megaboosh. 333, Monster Muffin. 420, Mad Megs. 422, Beaver Mansbridge. 747, Aims to Kill. 905, Ballerina. And L7, Tear Apart.
312, that is Killinois for Windy City, up against Mad Megs, number 420 for Toronto. And that is Mad Megs, so Toronto gets a lead game on the board.
Mad Megs, the leading point getter for Toronto this weekend with 158 points thus far.
Mad Megs makes a run, calls it off after picking up 0. Nice job by Windy.
So a couple of donuts there on the board. Do a quick run through of the Windy roster now. Number 116 is Max Savage, 138, a beat it down. 15, the Jam Burglar. 17, Mia Goham. 219, Who's Your Mama. 300, Christina Rego. 312, Killinois. Number 4, Jan Trainer. 43, Zombie Arthur. 434, T.S. Helliot. 55, Legal Tenderizer. 62, Mako. 622, Kidney Lopper. And 88, Rita Hayworthy.
And from the Fast Girls start line, Jan Trainer for Windy City up against Beaver Mansbridge for Toronto. And it is Beaver Mansbridge, who seems to run pretty hot and pretty cold at the same time, even in the same jam. Beaver Mansbridge having a great weekend. but getting caught up a few times. Coming up already. However, Jan Trainer hot on her tail, holds her to 3 points. But Toronto is on the board now, 4-3 in favor of Windy City with 27 and a half to go in the first half.
Lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. Bont, bont.com, the latest and greatest way to customize your Bont skates with my Bonts.
And in the fourth jam, we are going to have the fourth jammer, Lexicon for Toronto, and the fourth jammer for Windy as well, Rita Hateworthy, number 88, in the black and silver. First off, and Rita Hateworthy grabbing lead jam before she even hits the pivot line.
Windy taking full advantage of a small pack. It was just a 2-2 and opened up a big hole for Rita Hateworthy, and she took it up the inside.
Lexicon about a quarter of the track behind. Rita calls it off after picking up 3 points for Windy City.
As we were alluding to most of this weekend, both of these teams actually coming in this weekend with the bit of upheaval between last season's playoff and this. A lot of retirements and relocations on the Windy side. Toronto had the usual amount of attrition in the offseason. What we're seeing during the regular season, though, the injury bug hitting them hard, falling out of the injury tree and hitting every branch on the way down.
Ballerina up against Mia Goham. Ballerina is through, but she got knocked out to the outside.
Nice recycling there by Windy with the drawback all the way to turn four.
And Mia Goham has made it through on her pass as well. And has about a half a track on Ballerina, so Ballerina will call it off. That's why it's so important to grab that lead jammer status immediately, even if you get knocked back.
Get your league sponsored for product discounts. Email sponsorship at fastgirlskates.com. Fast Girl Skates, 8 years dedicated to making a faster you.
7-3 in favor of Windy City with 25:39 to go in this first half. Lining up, we have number 424, Toronto. That is Mad Megs. And we have 312, that is Killinois for Windy City.
Meg's Mad so Meg's powerful, Meg, yeah. Coming around the outside, just bullying her way around that pack. Has a good three quarters of a lap and growing advantage here on Killinois.
Killinois has made her initial pass now, but Meg's is heading her way through. Already has three and is going to stop at three. That brings Toronto up to six and within 1 point of Windy City.
The points coming in dribs and drabs here in the early going. Maddening, only 7-6 for Windy at this point. Both these teams running into a fair bit of penalty trouble this weekend. In their game against No Coast yesterday, Windy picking up 47 penalties. Toronto with similar numbers in their first game against Queen City, picking up 48. Going to try to keep those whiteboards a little bit cleaner in this one.
Beaver Mansbridge for Toronto up against Jan Trainer for Windy City. Mansbridge trying to get, Mansbridge with a forearm penalty. So that is going to be a Windy City power jam. As it happened to her, unfortunately, just past the point of no return. So she is going to have to go all the way around to take a seat. And that's going to be the first grand slam of the game. 5 big roller derby points for Windy City.
Low block penalty being issued to the pivot for Windy. That's Mako, number 62, going to the Derby Supply of Helly Mucks.
Trainer moving through. Getting tapped out. Nice movement there by Toronto. A nice little wedge pushing her out. Using 3 of their 4 blockers out on the pad. Beaver Mansbridge is released from the box. She's going to have to make it all the way through before she's even be able to begin scoring points. She's already removed her helmet cover. Does not pass it to her pivot. As Jan Trainer is through once again for an additional 5 points. That's 10 so far in this jam. Mansbridge puts the helmet cover back on as Trainer makes her third pass and calls it off after picking up 3 points. For Windy City.
She hits those blockers hard, but does get those 3. 13-0 jam for Windy. And we're seeing that so far here in the early going, lead jammer has gone to Toronto four times, but they've only managed to get 6 points with those four lead jammers, whereas Windy has picked up three leads and has early lead here on the scoreboard, Maddening.
Next up, new jammer for Windy City, Zombie Arthur. She's going up against number 25, Lexicon for Toronto.
Lexi and Beaver Mansbridge, the two of them are fairly recent additions to the Toronto roster. Lexi picking up lead jammer here, both coming from Toronto's B team, the Bay Street Bruisers.
And now, a track cut on Zombie Arthur in her initial jam out here. So she's going to take a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. And this will allow Toronto's Lexicon to run roughshod if her blockers can help her out a bit. Oh, right on through on the inside to pick up 5 points for Toronto.
Yeah, Mia Culprit and Tara Part, veterans of this roster, coming in, creating a disturbance in the force and opening up that hole. Now Lexi taking a fairly quick sojourn around the outside.
An additional five as she passes Ruthenesha there. Five more points. That's a total of 15 for Toronto, and Toronto takes the lead. One more attempt at a pass here. As she tries to get past that Windy City Chevron up at the front. And a track cut once again on Zombie Arthur out of the box and back in immediately. Was not able to pass off that star. She had it in her hand.
Still has it in her hand. It's not on her helmet, but she has taken it with her to the Derby Supply penalty box. Lexicon continuing on this big power jam for Toronto, already with 20.
And after that, Toronto's got to be feeling pretty good here, taking the lead 26-20 on a 20-point jam with just under 21 minutes to go in the first half.
Yeah, jammer penalties have also caused a lot of damage to these two teams this weekend. Windy's game against Montreal on Friday, picking up 12 jammer penalties, picked up 14 against No Coast yesterday. Toronto opened the weekend with a total of 16 against Queen City, but tightened that up a bit in their loss to Boston yesterday with only six. So they're going to see if they can keep that momentum going in that positive direction.
Ballerina has picked up one lead jam so far out of her on her three appearances. We'll see if she can go for two on a power jam. Zombie Arthur has been released, but your lead jammer is Ballerina of Toronto. Zombie Arthur has made it through on her initial pass as well. Ballerina making her scoring pass here. Makes it all, no, she got a back block, so she is going to be rushing to the Derby Supply penalty box, taking a seat as Zombie Arthur now is able to make up for the last jam. So Zombie Arthur is on the track up below to score. Oh, very close, but managed to crawl back in, removes the jammer cover, passes it off.
Yeah, that's Mako now. Mako took a couple of big star passes for Windy this weekend and has put up points when doing so. So Windy looking to mix things up here. That's 5 points already, closing the gap.
And Mako now getting past the last two as Ballerina is released. Mako has picked up an additional five. That's 10 so far. Ballerina with four.
And Max Savage and Lady Gaga went down in a heap. Max Savage drawing the penalty, and that opened up a bit of space for Bala on that last scoring pass.
Ballerina getting knocked around like a pachinko ball, but it manages to stay in, picking up an additional 4 points as Mako gets through as well. It's down to her knees on the inside, just millimeters inside. Four more points for Ballerina. And already around again as Mako is knocked to the outside and had to recycle to the back of the pack. And as the jam clock expires, an additional four for Toronto. So actually that was a 17 points for Windy City, that jam, 16 for Toronto.
Everybody scores as we use up all the available time on the clock. Roll faster and farther with Quick Ceramic Bearings. Quick Bearings. When you want quality, think Quick. And these two teams, this is now the third time all time in sanctioned play that they're meeting. They played last year at Division I playoffs in Evansville with Windy coming out on top 327-80. Previous to that, they played in March of 2013. Again, a big win at that time for Windy, 377-95. Both of these teams' rosters very different from what they were during those two games.
Mad Megs gets knocked to the inside alongside Mia Goham, both of having to recycle. And Mad Megs goes round the outside, picks up a lead jammer status. Mia Goham a little unsure on her legs there as she went through, but she seems to have recovered just fine. Mad Megs making a quick hit it and quit it, grabbing zero.
Yeah,
a little too quick.
Yeah, she went over the line a little bit sooner than she wanted to and had to get the hands on the hips, not in time to do any damage on the scoreboard. I've been handed a note here that Misery May, who's playing for Toronto in this game, number 101, this will be her last game as a bachelorette. She's getting married on the 16th of this month.
I wasn't invited, were you?
I was not invited either.
How dare they?
Yes.
All right, we had Killinois for Windy City up against Beaver Mansbridge for Toronto. Toronto leading by 5, 42-37 with 16:42 to go. And Killinois makes a break of it and is your lead jammer for Windy City. Beaver Mansbridge makes it through as well. So again, this is probably going to be a very quick one for Killinois. Getting through, calling off 4 points for Windy City, and Windy City comes within one.
If you have anything to say to us or about this game or about these teams or about this weekend, you can get to us using Twitter and the hashtag #TalkToWFTDA. That was the first lead in four jams for Windy, so they can capitalize on that with a quick 4-0.
Lexicon for Toronto up against Jan Trainer for Windy City. Jan Trainer just jumping around the back there, trying to figure out, go to the right, go to the left, gets knocked out to the outside, has to recycle.
Misery May with the drawback.
Once again on the inside. And a forearm penalty on Lexicon. So she's going to take a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. So this is all Windy City right now as Jan Trainer comes up on the back of the pack. And with a little help from her friends, makes it through. Oh no, a nice recycling there at the front by Toronto, but it's not enough for Jan Trainer, who picks up 5 points.
Yeah, and Yeke Igwe and Tara Park getting a little tangled up there, unable to slow Jan Trainer. Windy coming in for a nice looking sweep. However, Toronto counters.
Jan Trainer making her move, gets through for an additional 5 points. Grand slam for Windy City, and Windy City has taken the lead once again. 51-42, and already at the back of the pack. It's tapped to the inside, retreats, and a star pass to the aforementioned bachelorette, Misery May.
And right after that star pass, Lexicon switching to some defense, the hip flick that had taken Jan Trainer into the infield. Misery, a very powerful skater.
And Jan Trainer threw once again for an additional 4 points. Misery May did a bit of a stumble right before she runs into the Jam Burglar. Eventually does get through and puts 4 points on the board for Toronto. So after that jam, Windy City picked up in a total of 18. Toronto's 4. So that's Windy City 59, Toronto 46 with 13:50 to go. And we have a team timeout on Windy City.
Did you know that the WFTDA is celebrating 10 years of leadership in modern roller derby?
Strangely enough, I did.
Oh, you've been here all weekend. But in those 10 years...
Most of those 10 years, actually.
Yeah, the WFTDA has gone from 20 founding members to more than 400 leagues on 6 continents. We've got 6 continents in the books at this point. Decade never looks so good. Happy 10th anniversary to all of us as we celebrate the WFTDA community making a mark in the sport of roller derby.
I can't wait till we pick up that seventh continent with the McMurdo Maulers when they get to the apprentice program.
So jammer penalties starting to become an issue here for Toronto. They've only had three, but in those power jams, Windy has picked up 48 of their points. There's been two jammer penalties for Windy, and Toronto's only been able to get 20 points on those.
And when we restart, we're going to have Rita Hateworthy, number 88, for Windy City, up against Ballerina, number 905, for Toronto.
Just a total scrum here. Everybody knotted together, taking very slow seats. A forearm penalty is being called, looking to see who it's being called on.
But Ballerina makes it through and is lead jammer.
It's Christina,
followed about a half track behind by Rita Hateworthy, who's now pouring on the steam.
Christina Rago, the one that picked up that forearm penalty, taking a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. Toronto picks up four, and it's going to bring them to an even 50. Windy holding at 59, 13 minutes plus on the period clock. This, of course, the first of the final five games here at Omaha. This game determining a ninth place for the weekend.
Beaver Mansbridge wearing the jammer star for Toronto, but it is Mia Goham for Windy City who takes lead jammer status.
Mia Goham very explosive off the start line, very quickly getting through. Already on a scoring pass, Beaver Mansbridge still has half a lap to make up.
Mia Goham gets knocked to the outside and calls it off. Picks up 3 points for Windy City, bringing them up to 63. 4 points, pardon me.
Flying Brian McKillman.
Oh, and 3 points were given to Toronto there. They weren't given to Toronto.
No,
Toronto scored those points.
They earned them. Flying Brian was out there having a quick word with the officials. But just a little quick, hey, how you doing? Good morning. How's your weekend been? And back at the bench.
We've got Mad Megs versus Killinois here for Toronto and Windy City, respectively. Mad Megs sees that inner run there and makes it through. But, oh, with a multiplayer block on the jammer.
Yeah, she was trying to take a whip off of the jersey of Lady Gaga, and unfortunately, that incurred that multiplayer block.
Killinois about to make her run here. Her first scoring pass this jam, and does it. Five big roller derby points for Windy City. And already around again, ready to make her move. The Windy City Pack trying to break up those Toronto blockers.
Aims to kill, last line of defense at the front, has to let Killinois go. Killinois now in double digits on this jam with 10 points, and Windy's lead is up to 20. Mad Megs with the star in hand on this stash, having returned from the Derby Supply penalty box. Justice signaling to call the jam. However, Killinois cannot call the jam. Killinois getting a blocking out of play penalty. You do not see that happen very often for a jammer, but if you're out of the engagement zone, can't engage with somebody who's not the other jammer.
Good news for Toronto. Mad Megs has one more blocker to beat. Windy City bridging.
It's a very impressive bridge when you've only got those three skaters out there.
5 points for Toronto. And still 11 seconds on the jam clock. Mad Megs getting battered around a bit. She's past two already. She's past three. She had passed all four. All right, for Toronto, that brings them up to 9 this jam. Windy City with 11, so that's a total of Windy City 74, Toronto 62 with just under 10 minutes remaining in the first half.
Now we're seeing both managers out in the infield. Justice speaking with the Jammer ref, seeing Brian speaking with the head ref. Quick run through of the officiating crew for this game. The crew head referee is DJ Jazzy Ref. The inside pack ref is Ump. Duke Skellington, Code Adam, the Jammer refs, Ogre, Justmo, Johnny Demonic, the OPRs, and Spankin' DeMonkey is our alt official.
And Windy City was given an additional point at the end there. Just a little confusion between the two, but Justice Feelgood Marshall, always with an eye on things, figured it out. Jan Trainer is your lead jammer for Windy City and has already gone through and picked up 5 points. Lexicon, the helmet cover was dropped.
Got alerted there by her teammate Rennie Rumble. Almost skated away without it.
Nice little hop of an apex jump there. 5 more points for Windy City, that bringing them to 10 total this jam so far.
Windy starting to run into some penalty trouble. Hoosier Mama already taking her 5th trip to the Derby Supply penalty box.
And 2 more points on that last pass before the time expires. So that brings Windy City to 87, Toronto 62. So a 25-point advantage for Windy City right now.
Made in the USA and made for Derby, that's Rydell Skates. Rydell Skates offer unmatched quality and unmatched performance. Handcrafting quality roller skates for 70 years. RydellSkates.com.
And the whistle blows and they are off. Windy City has Mia Goham jumping off the fast girl start line, but Ballerina takes the day for Toronto. Mia Goham still at the back of the pack, makes a break for it as Ballerina gets her initial pass starting, but a nice run there.
Ballerina gets taken just to the line, straddles, has to go back, loses a little bit of momentum. That's just the initial pass though for Mia Goham.
So Ballerina calls it off after picking up 5 points for Toronto, 5 unanswered points. That brings Toronto up to 67, so an even 20-point differential right now.
The Jackson Skates offer more bang for your buck. Bionic, Pilot, Vertigo, put that together. That is a winning combination. Jackson Skate, for the love of it, Jackson Skates.
Beaver Man's Bridge for Toronto. And that name was just explained to me.
Mm-hmm.
I consider myself as a Minnesotan connoisseur of all things Canadian, but the Peter Mansbridge joke flew over my head. Killinois for Windy City.
Missed it by that much.
Beaver Mansbridge having some trouble up at the front of the pack, but she makes it around with a little bit of help from her friends.
Yeah, Misery May came in and just swept those two Windy blockers.
But man, look at Killinois with that speed there. Beaver Mansbridge has the decision to make, calls it. Oh, 3 points for Toronto, 2 for Windy City.
Yeah, Windy with the steal. Call off not quite in time.
Just the amazing speed on Killinois. She's one of the few players on Windy City that has been with them for a few years now. And she's having a heck of a game so far, and she's just one of the speediest skaters you'll ever see.
Yeah, overall, Windy with only 5 skaters returning from last playoffs charter. So Jan, this is a new team finding their legs.
Jan Trainer gets knocked way to the inside. Oh, dear me. As Mad Megs becomes lead jammer for Toronto. Trainer with a forearm penalty. There's a little confusion about what penalty that was.
Yes, because the jammer ref was also having to tell her that because of where she incurred that penalty, she was going to have to come back and then skate all the way around. So we saw a couple of conflicting hand motions while he was giving those directions in order.
So Mad Megs getting caught up there with legal tenderizer. Controlling the front of the pack.
Megs.
What a nice push out there on Megs.
Yeah, legal tenderizer tenderizing the jammer.
Windy City getting back together, getting their blockers back together, all 4 on the pack, on the track.
Toronto taking the back wall as they see the starless Jan Trainer coming out of the box.
And a forearm penalty, again, this time against legal tenderizer, having to go all the way around again. Jan Trainer is through on her initial pass and has put the star back on her helmet. Mad Megs calls it off. She did pick up 5 points there.
Very hard fought for those 5 points. Christina Rago and Abita Down, and the two of them tag teaming on Mad Megs with the hits and drawbacks. Bit of soul crushing happening there. Lee Jammer going so far here. 11 turns for Toronto. Wendy's only had 7, but Wendy's still with that 13-point lead. Seems to consistently get beyond 13, and then it comes back to 13. It's elastic, this lead.
Mia Goham for Windy City up against Ballerina for Toronto. Ballerina, you can see on your screen there, having to deal with 3 Windy City blockers with only the assistance of number 101, Misery May, at the front of the pack, who bridged a little bit, but she is through and is your lead jammer. Mia Goham also takes advantage of the confusion, gets through for her initial pass. Ballerina making her scoring pass now, calls it off after picking up 3. So that brings Toronto to 10-point difference right now. They are at 78. Windy City is at 88, 3 minutes, 33 seconds to go.
We wouldn't sell it if we wouldn't play, and it's the first, the best, and happy to fix the rest. That is SinCityskates.com. And I was just saying that there's only 5 returning skaters from last playoffs charter here for Windy City. On the Toronto side of the ledger, they've only got 9 skaters that were on the charter at the beginning of this year.
Oh boy.
That are here this weekend. Lots of changes happening there.
Rita Hateworthy, front of the pack, dealing with those Toronto blockers. Beaver Mansbridge having a little trouble at the back. In fact, she has 4 to deal with. You can see the 2 different styles there. Rita Hateworthy just pushing. Beaver Mansbridge jumping around, trying to figure out a way to get around her. Rita Hateworthy trying to cut to the inside. Doesn't work. Try to cut to the outside. Also blocked by Toronto. Fantastic defense at the front of the pack from Toronto. Beaver Mansbridge, though, also having the same trouble at the back of the pack. But then, all of a sudden, from out of nowhere, Mega Boosh comes in, breaks things up a little bit. Hateworthy was through and already on her scoring pass here.
Yeah, Rita Hateworthy got sprung when Rennie Rumble picked up a direction of gameplay penalty. Mega Boosh tries to drop the bomb, but it's a dud, unfortunately. And for her, is Rita Hateworthy with another 5 points going on the board for Windy.
As Mansbridge has removed her jammer cover and put it back on now. Rita Hateworthy, seeing that Mansbridge made it through on her initial pass, decides to call it off after picking up 4 more points. So Windy City is at 97 after picking up 9 that last jam. Toronto still at 78. 1 minute, 43 seconds to go. Time for 1, possibly 2 more jams in this first half.
At the conclusion of today, we will know who the final 12th team is who's going to qualify for Division I playoffs next month in St. Paul, Minnesota. And you won't want to miss a minute of that championship tournament. Get your watch pass now for only $22.50 on WFTDA.tv.
Illinois through for Windy City. Mad Megs working it. Gets knocked to the outside. Has to retreat all the way back. Illinois already on her scoring pass. Oh, and nice. That Chevron defense from Toronto. But gets broken up by Windy. Illinois gets tapped to the inside. Almost had it in.
Misconduct being called on Mad Megs, going to take a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box. This is another power jam for Windy City. Windy City already with the 19-point lead and less than a minute left on the period clock. Illinois in the driver's seat on this power jam.
And another Toronto blocker off to the box as Illinois tries to get through this slightly lighter pack here. Windy City makes a move. Illinois has picked up all 5 points. 102-78. Windy City scored 5 points.
Would not be surprised to see if Flying Brian calls an official review here in the dying seconds so he doesn't have to burn a timeout. And that is indeed what we're seeing happen here. I think it was a bit of Windy daring them once it got under the 30-second mark. We're gonna call this off and see if you want to get another jam in. You've already used one team timeout. And so he's going to use his first half official review. And we'll find out shortly from DJ Jazzy Ref what the nature of that review is. We'd like to do some shout-outs and thank yous. The WFTDA would like to thank Sin City Skates, 5-on-5 Magazine, Something Inked, and our friends at Derby Central. Of course, we also want to thank our host, the Omaha Roller Girls. And if you were watching last night, you maybe didn't have the benefit of sound, but you had the benefit of sight during the halftime show. And DJ Jazzy Ref.
Together for our medical
team. Toronto is challenging the lack of a low block call on the Windy City blocker and the previous jam.
So actually an official review being used to officially review something.
Yeah, so they're going to see if they can get the Windy jammer, who was Killanoy on that jam. They're going to see if they can get her in the box and see if they can get a little more points on the board before they go into the half. Scoreboard currently showing a 102 for Windy City, 78 for Toronto. Clock was stopped with 5 seconds on the period clock.
And when it begins again, Mad Megs is standing, so she has less than 10 seconds remaining in her penalty. So she'll be rejoining very soon.
Upon review, the OPR clarifies that the contact was upper thigh to upper thigh, so it's legal target zone to legal blocking zone. No penalty will be assigned. Toronto will not retain their official review for this half.
All right, there we go.
Very thorough, clear explanation from DJ Jazzy Ref. I would not expect anything less from him.
5 seconds remaining in the half. But of course, as you all know, as Derby aficionados, this can go for up to 2 full minutes.
Up to 2 minutes, you say?
2 full minutes. The whistle blows, and there we go. Jan Trainer jamming alone for Windy City, but Mad Megs has jumped in. But Jan Trainer is your lead jammer already. Mad Megs has also made it through quite quickly. So this will be a very quick jam, as Jan Trainer is probably just going to score a couple points and then call it off. Gets the whip through. No, she does not call it off.
No, she's going to go for more. Yeah. She's got time.
5 points for Jan Trainer. 4 points for Mad Megs. This time she calls it off. Did not score any points that one, but that's all right. Windy City with a nice little 25-point lead, 107-82 over Toronto at half. So, yeah, a very nice first half. It started out a little
tentative, yeah, I would say.
Yeah, folks getting 1, 2, 3, 4 points per jam.
Look at that whiteboard, though. We are seeing some folks in penalty trouble over on the Windy side. That's going to be Hoosier Mama already with 6 box trips on the Toronto side of the ledger. Misery May with 4. It will have a more complete report on penalties and points at the conclusion of halftime. But again, both teams here vying to go out on a high note. Mm-hmm. They are playing here for the 9th place game.
Yep. But also the 10th place game. So that's I think when you get down that, when
you're playing against the 10th place game.
Well, it's true. I mean, when they get to this low, a lot of it is, yeah, we want to win, but we don't want to lose. So that can a team that's been having trouble all weekend, that's kind of gives them the extra fire in their belly to try to make it run. So we'll be back in just about 10 minutes to talk to you again. Thank you for joining us on, this is the third day of the final Division I tournament in the 2015 International WFTDA Tournament season. We'll see you in about 10 minutes. Hey, and we are back for the second half of Toronto versus Windy City. Windy City with a 106-82 lead over Toronto right now. But a very very fun game so far. Very close right at the beginning. A few 2-3 point jams back and forth, and then zoom.
Zoom indeed.
Zoom.
And they're really zooming onto the penalty boards, actually.
Oh boy.
They've been zooming in and out of the Derby Supply penalty box all night. So far, Windy with 27 box trips, 25 for Toronto. Toronto with 5 jammer penalties. Windy has 4. And the power jam points are really what the difference is right now. We've got a lead of, what is that? That is 24 points. We have a 21-point advantage on those power jams in Windy's favor. They've got 55 points on power jams, 34 for Toronto. Toronto is winning the lead jammer game 12-10 at this point. Have to see what happens here in the second half. Big story, Mad Meg's leading scorer in Toronto's previous two games this weekend. Here she's been held to only 21 so far in this game. So I believe Justice and the good folks at Windy City did some studying last night and got into the stats repository. You can get into the stats yourself also at http://stats-repo.wftda.com. You can find all the games from this weekend. They've been really great about getting all that information uploaded really quickly. You can see exactly who's doing what.
So somebody that you might not see out as much in the second half for Windy City is Who's Your Mama, mm-hmm. who already has 6 trips to the box, one more, of course, and she'll be watching the game from back in her locker room. So either they're going to put her out and she's going to promise to be better, to be good, or they're just going to hold back on her until they actually need her later in the game. But both teams with full complements of 14 skaters. So it's not like one of these teams that started off with 12 and they lose a couple and just becomes a horrible tired ratio action.
Well, and Amos Akil, co-captain of Toronto, had a plate break on her skate earlier this weekend. So that almost happened, but she was able to get that repaired and is playing this game.
Illinois out of the gun there. Lead jammer status for Windy City as Bell Arena keeps on getting tapped out over in. Oh, and a track cut on Bell Arena as she had tried to pass the star. 5 points scored already by Illinois, and already back again, making a move, and is through for an additional 5 points. That's 10 so far this jam for Illinois and Windy City.
Kilnoy looking very strong so far in this game, has 32 points. Only one box trip, playing very clean.
Both teams at full strength out there with the exception of that jammer, Ballerina for Toronto, who has just been released from the Derby Supply penalty box. As Kilnoy makes another trip around, that's 5 more points for Windy City. Ballerina trying to make her initial pass here. As Illinois comes through, Ballerina round through the inside on her initial pass. Illinois sees it, however, and calls off the jam. She picked up 1 point on that last pass, and that brings Windy City to a total of 16 for that jam. Another nice big move for them. 16 unanswered points, so Toronto's still sitting at 82, Windy City 122.
Be a lifer, get a lifer, S1 Helmets. S1 Helmets are rad. Get rad at S1Helmets.com.
I wish I could be rad.
No, I have a feeling you might be flameproof, though, with the that outfit that you are wearing today.
It's Sparkle Sunday. Jan Trainer for Windy City up again against Mad Megs for Toronto, and Jan Trainer finds a hole on the inside. Speedy enough around the corner there. The jam ref took a bit of a tumble, but is right back in the thick of it. Jan Trainer cut to the outside and then juked over to the inside, but got tapped out, so she had to recycle to the back of the pack as Mad Megs, still trying to make her initial pass, takes a bit of a knee, comes back up. Still that diamond defense there on the front. Oh, and she just had a skate cut to the inside of the track, so she goes all the way back again. She was so very close, and a low block on Tara Part out of Toronto. But at the very least, it held Jan Trainer back a little bit. Kind of a sacrifice fly there. Mad Megs has made it through just as the jam is called, but 5 points were scored by Jan Trainer.
Windy City currently on a 40-5 run over the last 5 jams. Toronto yet to score here in the second half. Scoreboard showing 127-82. Just about 26 and a half minutes plus on the period clock. Beaver Mansbridge returning to the Fast Girls start line.
She's going up against Mia Goham for Windy City. Oh, Mia Goham tapped to the outside, but she is a lead jammer. She got her hips in front of the final blocker in front before she was tapped out. Mansbridge pushing through. Bridging happening from Windy City. Oh, and just sloughing off skaters as the Derby Supply penalty box is filling up. Only four blockers, on the track right now. 4 points scored by Windy City as that penalty box fills up.
Yeah, the white and pink is becoming the dominant color fashion accessory in the Derby Supply penalty box.
But Windy City, not to be outdone, also has two players in there as well. So we have a very light pack, two blockers for each team as Killinoy takes on Lexicon. But man, those light packs are still very tough. Killinoy makes it through.
Both teams putting out some wrecking balls there in the blocking core. And Misery May, who's now on her way to the penalty box for a direction of gameplay penalty, was out there to start this one with Anyeka Igwe, Mako, and Christina Rego, the blockers for Windy City. So we're seeing a lot of collisions here. Seventh straight lead jammer going to Windy.
Killinoy gets through and calls it off. 0 points for Toronto. Windy City was able to pick up nine, and we have a team timeout called by Toronto.
So good time for Toronto. Haven't yet to score in this half. They are now down by 58 points. Clock stopped at 24:52. And the International WFTDA Playoffs and Championships bring together the most talented skaters and teams in the FTDA. You've been seeing them all weekend here in Omaha. But next month, join us November 6th to the 8th for the 2015 International WFTDA Championships, hosted by the Minnesota.
The Minnesota Roller Girls at the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium in beautiful downtown St. Paul. We hope to see you there. It is one of the most iconic arenas in modern flat track roller derby. The Minnesota Roller Girls were the first modern roller derby team to play in a professional sports venue. And still every month flipping it up, filling it up, having lots of fun. And we would love to share it with the world.
So live it or stream it live at WFTDA.com/champs. That's next month. Coming from St. Paul.
Rita Hateworthy wearing the Jammer Star for Windy City up against Ballerina for Toronto. And a push once again here. Rita Hateworthy tapped to the outside. Ballerina now taking on the front of the pack. Oh, Rita Hateworthy makes it through, cuts through the inside, becomes lead jammer. Ballerina around the outside and is a half track behind.
Both these teams, it looks like we're seeing them keep a couple of lanes open. They're not closing the doors quite as much. We're not seeing too many cuts forced on jammers. So that's leaving a little bit of room for jammers on both sides to take a lane and a half on either the inside or outside line and get those lead jammers.
Yeah, great work there by the Toronto blockers as well as Ballerina with that speed, forcing her to call it off after only picking up 2 points for Windy City, holding her to two. 142-82, so that's a 60-point difference right now. 23 minutes, 49 seconds to go as Mako wears the Jammer Star for Windy City up against Mad Megs.
Yeah, Windy's been using Mako as a bit of a reset jammer. Doesn't pay off here. This is the first lead jammer in quite some time for Toronto and Mad Megs. Windy, you know, like we said, Windy has been working hard on shutting down Megs, who's been the most dangerous jammer for Toronto this weekend, but can't quite close the door there. She picks up a 5-point scoring pass.
Grand slam for Toronto, and will this be what the break in the armor, break in the wall? Mako is through on her initial pass. So Mad Megs is going to be held to around 7, it looks like. But hey, that's a 7-0 jam for Toronto. Nothing to sneeze at. 89-142 with just under 23 minutes to go in this game.
All your derby needs, derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
And we can see the Derby Supply booth from here in our dais. And they have been busy all weekend providing great gear, great support to all the skaters here.
Timeout being called currently. Okay, yes, there's the hand signal. So there's actually going to be an official review being called by Toronto. Flying Brian has come out to speak with the officials. I've got a note here that in his days as a rapper, Flying Brian went as McFly Bry. So there's some information for you.
All right. What's the what is the veracity of the information?
We just go with what's been handed to us. I can give you some actual useful information, though. Lady Gaga, who's standing on the track now with CN Power, number 212, Lady Gaga is actually currently skating in her 74th sanctioned game Toronto.
Toronto is challenging the lack of a cut track call on the Windy City Jammer in the previous jam in turn one.
So we have the nature of the review and the location of the alleged infraction. So lots of information ought to lead to a fairly quick discussion by the officials with all that available information.
Absolutely. The Zebras huddle. And there's a look at the whiteboard. Still, once again, that's Hoosier Mama with those six trips to the box.
Three other skaters on Windy with four, though. It's Christina Rago, number 43 is Zombie Arthur, and 55 Legal Tenderizer. On the Toronto side, Misery May now with five trips. We're also seeing Rennie Rumble and Tear Apart. They're down at the bottom of that list, also with four box trips. Aims to Kill, so far skating clean. Number 747, co-captain for Toronto. She's in heavy usage and rotation. Mia Goham keeping it clean too, and that allows her to jam. Also 622 Kidney Lopper has skated nine clean jams thus far.
You are seeing a lot of forearm penalties here. If you take a look, that's the F on the whiteboard.
Yeah, earlier this weekend, both teams running into track cutting issues. Their game against No Coast, Windy picked up 15 of those.
Oh, boy.
Toronto picked up 10 of their own against Queen City. The big problem for Toronto in that game was direction of gameplay penalties with a staggering 17 of those. So not seeing as much of that happening. Both teams have cleaned up their acts in those regards.
All right. Let's get back to GJ Jesse Ruff.
On review, the Toronto Jammer's hips were behind the Windy City Jammer. The Toronto Blocker's hips were behind the Windy City Jammer's hips at the point she went out of bounds. The Windy City Blocker was not the initiator, so the Windy City Jammer did not have to re-enter the track behind her. There will not be a cut track assessed, and Toronto will not retain their review for the half.
Well, that is unfortunate for Toronto, as that gets rid of their official review, and they have only one team timeout remaining.
And I'm going to fill out a bingo square and let you know that currently Windy still has a full complement of timeouts and an official review at their disposal.
Beaver Mansbridge wearing the Jammer Star for Toronto up against Killinois for Windy City.
Beaver engaging right off the line there with Killinois, feeding her to her blockers.
Beaver Mansbridge jumping around like you've been seeing her do all weekend long.
She's a very toe-stoppy jammer.
Just tap, tap, tapping on her toes all the way, trying to get through, trying to get around.
Tap.
Some nice recycling up at the front of the pack there by Toronto. Stopping Killinois, making her figure out a new way to try to get through. Beaver Mansbridge. Does she see that hole? She does not, unfortunately for her. Mansbridge back to about two-thirds of the way back through the pack. Killinois making a move, but gets tapped out to the outside. Excellent defense from both of these teams, trying to force some cuts here, pushing these players to the outside.
Toronto lost their pivot, Rennie Rumble, during that last attempt on a high blocking penalty. That's her fifth trip to the Derby Supply penalty box.
Illinois with one more to beat.
Sleeper hold and aims to kill all over Illinois. That took a minute to 12 seconds. And Beaver Mansbridge getting hit hard there by Rita Hateworthy into the infield. Beaver stashing the star down her shirt, going to go to try to complete this initial on the incognito.
5 points scored by Illinois, bringing Windy City up to 147.
Rennie Rumble, though, kind of quietly comes back from the Derby Supply penalty box, able to receive a star pass, however, unable to do anything with it as
additional
Jan is called.
Additional 4 points scored there by Windy City that bring them up to 151. Toronto with 89, 20 minutes, 50 seconds to go in this game.
In the second half so far, Toronto has only scored 7 points.
And they all came on one jam, the sixth jam of the game. Or of the half, pardon me.
So Windy on quite a run right now. They have really turned things around.
Valerena for Toronto up against Jan Trainer. Valerena up at the front of the pack. Jan Trainer at the back. Jan Trainer, though, cuts around the outside. Just hops around. It's a walking eagle to get on through.
Yeah, encountering no resistance on the outside as everybody was occupied on the inner two lanes. And now it's same thing, takes the inside as everybody's on the outside.
Oh, big hits on Ballerina. She's taken off the star. But unfortunately, she's kind of waving it around like a flag, so folks are actually seeing it. Part of the star stash is kind of making it less visible.
So it's a bit like challenging the bull.
Yeah. Oh, she's Ballerina holding her nose there. I think she got a couple shots to the chest and then to the face. Nothing egregious, but she's holding her nose there. Hopefully she's all right.
So a big jam there for Jan Trainer. She's put up 9 more points, leading point getter in this game at this point with 61 total. And it's you know, the old line about hockey players and Wayne Gretzky was, oh, you go to where the puck is going to be. And Jan Trainer is going where the blockers are not going to be, and she's finding those openings.
That was a nice stop there by Sleeperholm, holding her back.
All over Rennie Rumble.
I'm sorry, that's Lady Gaga. Lady Gaga, pardon me. Nice stop there as Mad Megs becomes lead jammer for Toronto. Mia Goham making a move as well, this second time through, second attempt through, as Mad Megs. You can see her right there on your screen getting stomped by that four wall of Windy City players. Cuts around the outside and calls it off after picking up 4 points for Toronto.
And again, we're seeing those Windy blockers just sticking like glue around Mad Megs. You had Abita down, you had T.S. Helliot. They've all been swarming her and not giving her really a lot of room. So it's taking her a lot longer to get through on the scoring passes than she was used to earlier this weekend.
New jammer minutes for Windy City, the Jam Burglar. Gonna try something out here. She's going up against Lexicon. Windy City has used 7 different jammers so far this game. Toronto's sticking with 4.
And 4 on the floor, literally lying on the floor. We had all those blockers down with Lexicon at turn 1, but she somehow emerges, picks up lead jammer.
Jam Burglar about a half track behind. And when a non-traditional jammer can get through before the first point pass, it's always a good thing. 2 points for Toronto.
So with those 2 points, that's actually the first time that Toronto has scored on consecutive jams in this half, Maddening. They're knocking on the door of the triple digit mark.
Mad Megs wearing the jammer star for Toronto as we have an official timeout being called. Illinois will be jamming for Windy City when we begin again. Toronto with 1 player in the box.
That's Mia Culprit. Mia Culprit, that's actually her first box trip of the game, so she's been playing quite cleanly. Longtime veteran member of Toronto Roller Derby. Flying Brian speaking here with DJ Jazzy Ref.
Taking advantage of the of the official timeout to state his case.
Case stated. Signal going that we're going to get back underway shortly.
One of the refs coming out here to chat with our scorekeepers. Wanting to make sure, even with a 65-point lead right now.
They've actually put Lexicon in the Derby Supply penalty box. So we can get some information about that. We will pass that on to you. But they've determined that there was an infraction occurred at some point in that previous jam. So this is a power start now for Windy. Windy has already been capitalizing on these power jams, maddening.
As Killinoy. Oh, and a nice waterfall attack. Well, modified waterfall attack as Killinoy makes it through on her initial pass. Windy City losing T.S. Helliott to the Derby Supply penalty box. Killinoy getting bashed out on the inside. Retreating. Toronto is able to focus solely on defense right now. Trying to hold back Killinoy.
And it was a skating out of bounds penalty that had been assessed to Lexicon on that previous jam, but she has now completed her time in the Derby Supply penalty box, is back out on the track.
5 points scored by Killinoy. Lexicon with a track cut. No, it
is waving her back.
They're waving her back onto the track.
Clarification, it was actually a no pass on penalty. So that's a bit of a lifesaver for Toronto.
She's through on her initial pass. Unfortunately, that slowed her down a bit. Killinoy calls off the jam before any points are able to be scored by Lexicon. So that was a 5-0 jam for Windy City. They're at 165. Toronto is at 95. That is 70 points in favor of Toronto with just over half the game to go. Oh, an additional 3 points have been added to Windy City, so they are at 168. 15:42 to go in this game.
They're pretty much at the halfway point here of the second half.
As Jan Trainer out there against Mad Megs for Windy City. Mad Megs having a deal up at the front. Moving back and forth and back and forth. Jan Trainer using her skaters to her advantage, pushing and pulling on them, getting on through, becoming lead jammer. Number 300, Christina Rega, has taken a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box as well for Windy City. As Toronto is now empty, Toronto side of the penalty box is now empty. 0 points for Toronto and an additional 4 for Windy.
With that lead jammer being awarded to Windy, that was their 9th one of the half to only 3 for Toronto. So 75% of the lead jammers have gone Windy's way here in the second half. Performance plates for the modern derby game come from Paradyne. Paradyne has cutting edge designs and cutting edge performance.
Ballerina for Toronto up against number 17, Mia Goham for Windy City. Windy City with a one blocker disadvantage, and now it's even as an additional Toronto blocker heads on in for a multiplayer block. Mia Goham calls it after picking up 3, but Toronto is able to grab 3, pardon me. So it was a 3-3 jam.
So that's a draw.
No differential change. 175 to 98 for Windy City. 13:45 to go.
77-point lead here for Windy.
So good mathing.
A lot of ground to make up here for Toronto with 13 and a half minutes left on the period clock. A timeout being called. It's an official timeout.
They head on over to, and it's a
misconduct. Misconduct being signaled for Ballerina, and Flying Brian, as soon as he gets that word, he's coming right out to speak with
Absolutely.
DJ Jazzy Ref about this. Can't call a review, though, unfortunately, because he had already used their official review. So a misconduct was called. This is now going to be a power start for Windy.
And the whistle blows, and we are off. Killen, oh, and just able to get right on through there for lead jammer status for Windy City. Already around and beginning, ready to begin her scoring pass. Doesn't try to make the easy run for it. She jumps around through the inside, then cuts down to the outside to take on those two blockers. Does, picks up 5 points.
And Misery May trapped here at the back of that four wall, unable to join her teammates up at the front. They do now have three others up there on Yekeegwe. Aims to kill and tear apart, trying to open up a spot for Ballerina, and they do. Christina Rago taking a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box for Windy City. That's her fifth box trip. Sorry, her sixth just got updated. Two skaters on six now for Windy, and Hoosier Mama and Christina Rago.
4 points for Windy City on that last pass for 9 total for the jam. 184 to 98 in favor of these skaters from Chicago. 12 and a half to go in this game.
And with 12:21 on the period clock, now it's a palindrome. Palindrome brought to you by Radar Cigar. Toss it in a can, it is so tragic. RadarWheels.com.
Jan Trainer wearing the number 4 for Windy City is also wearing the Jammer Star. But the lead jammer is Mad Megs from Toronto.
Lady Gaga taken down hard at turn one by the Jam Burglar. No call comes in for that contact. Lady Gaga looked like she wanted a call for that contact.
Yeah, she was looking up before she even got up. She was looking up at the refs like, come on, seriously? 4 points for Toronto, and that brings them past the century mark. 102, Windy City still at 184. As Mia Goham is flowing. Flowing on a beautiful little dance move. She's she's a reed in the wind, lexicon, jamming for Toronto. And just she just jumps into the breach there. A lot of power from Lexicon there. And she makes it through. Lead jammer status goes to Toronto.
Mia Culprit,
oh,
dropping the hammer on Mia Goham. Mia Goham now with the star in hand, having re-entered play.
Abita down, knocking out Lexicon, stopping her forward progress. And a star pass to number 116, Max Savage, who doesn't have time to show what she can do with it. 4 points for Toronto, bringing them up to 106. Windy City, 184.
That was a very quick star pass there from Mia Goham. Got to wonder if that contact she had from Mia Culprit maybe knocked a little bit of something out of her. And she's like, you know what? This isn't you do this.
Yeah.
That was quite a hit. And Mad Megs now back on the Fast Girl star line for Toronto. Mad Megs has quietly now taken the lead in scoring for Toronto with 36 and has picked up, of their four lead jammers of this half, three of them belong to her. So she seems to have found a bit of an answer for the Windy Blockers.
Mad Megs taking a hit. And taking a track cut.
And as I say that, there she goes, skating in tandem with Mako right now. to the Derby Supply.
No, she got pulled back. No, a little more confusion. It was Mako's track cut. So unfortunately for Mad Megs, that totally screwed up her first pass through. So now she has made her initial pass, but Rita Hateworthy controls the jam and she calls it off. Mad Megs initially, as soon as whistle blew, a nice little hip check onto Rita, knocking her not inside the track, but just to the inside line, and tried to make a run for it. Got stopped up a little bit, but luckily for her, there was that confusion on the track.
Yeah, Justice Feelgood out there now getting some clarification on what that was about. Flying Brian follows. Getting some other folks in penalty trouble, though. Rennie Rumble, wearing the pivot stripe currently for Toronto, is in the box for her sixth time. So she's knocking on the door of danger. Again, and two skaters on the windy side. Hoosier Mama and Christina Rego in that same boat.
Bale Arena is your lead jammer for Toronto, followed very closely by Killinoy. And there you see, again, Killinoy in that low speed skating stance. Toronto gets four, calls it off. 110 to Windy City's 187.
So still 77 points separating these two teams. Just under 8.5 minutes left on the period clock. Get all the scores, recaps, brackets, and more at WFTDA Tournament Central. Find that online on the WFTDA website using the URL WFTDA.com/tournaments, plural, and locate Omaha if you want to find out more about what's happened here in Omaha.
Mia Goham up against Mad Megs. Mad Megs at the back of the pack. Mia Goham at the front, but Mad Megs cuts around the outside and becomes lead jammer for Toronto again.
That's her fourth time with lead jammer in this half. Toronto on a bit of a run, small run, but a 12-3 run over the last four jams.
Megs gets through the pack and calls it off, but not in time. 2 points scored by Windy City, 4 points scored by Toronto.
Yep.
Very unfortunate move there for Toronto.
Mia Goham, very excited coming off the track.
Seeing, I would be too.
And not just because the jammer ref is putting up the goat horns, it's what those goat horns mean. She got stole those 2 points. So the jam still is a 2-point advantage for Toronto. Now down by 75 points, 7 minutes plus on the period clock. Justice, as Justice does, waits till almost the end of the 30 seconds. Calls the timeout, milks that extra time and rest for the team. See the team here all gathered around. This is a big game here for Windy City. Windy City this year in sanctioned play going 1-7. Their only victory thus far this year in May against Madison. There's a narrow 7-point victory, 200-193. Right now,
but I believe then later in the season, Madison beat them as
by
well
26
by 26 points. So Windy City wanting. It's not really bragging rights. Windy City wants to go home with their heads held high. They want to go home with a win in their pocket.
Yep.
And so does Toronto.
And this team that we're seeing here, the Windy City Rollers All-Stars, they've been gelling over the course of this weekend.
Absolutely.
Yeah, like some scary point differentials on the scoreboard earlier this weekend for them, but they've really been coming together, and they're going to be very happy if they can keep the control of this game. Toronto coming in with only 14 skaters this weekend, a couple of last-minute issues on their roster, cookie dough tearing a meniscus in practice this past week. Santa Muerte dealing with a family emergency. A lot of the skaters been wearing her number 111 on their calves, thinking of her.
Bale Arena for Toronto right now up against Jan Trainer, jumping off of the fast girl start line. As the scrum keeps on keeping on, Bale Arena making a move around the outside. Jan Trainer is your lead jammer. Ballerina, about a third of a track behind, quarter of a track behind.
And closing.
Yeah.
Third of a track, quarter of a track, fifth of a track.
All right, 1 point for Toronto. 115, two late points coming in. 191 for Windy City, Toronto with 115, 6 minutes 21 seconds remaining in this game.
Ballerina did incur a penalty there on the end for that collision at the call-off. So again, taking a seat in the Derby Supply penalty box, that's Balla's fourth box trip of the game.
Killinoy jamming alone right now. Killinoy is through in turn one as your lead jammer. She's had 73 points so far this game. Has a 62% lead jammer status.
Aims to kill with the drawback. Going to kill a little bit of time for this power kill for Toronto.
Killinoy cutting around the outside and then jukes to the inside. Picks up five for Windy City. That'll bring him up to 196 within 4 points of the double century mark. Ballerina back in. Passes the star to Rennie Rumble.
Bold strategy move there. Rennie Rumble has six box trips on the ledger.
And one more point is added to Windy City's total. That'll bring them up to 197, 3 points from the double century mark. Toronto still with 1:15, 0 points scored on that last jam.
But yes, as I was saying, that pays off for them in the end, as she does at least get the jam forced to call. Toronto seems to be double shifting Mad Megs at this point. So she's back out on the Fast Girls start line once again with the star for Toronto.
Against Mia Goham, and she, oh boy, Mad Megs takes it straight away. But we have a downed player on the track right now for Windy City.
Yeah, Christina Rego right off the start went down hard and stayed down.
The fine volunteer medical staff, including Windy City's own Mama and Papa Doc out there.
Having a look here at the Windy bench. Have a look here at Toronto. Toronto bench actually looking fairly calm.
I mean, they're tired. They know they have a long way to go and only 44 minutes and 45 seconds to go. But they do look calm. They look like they have a plan. Mm-hmm. They want to finish strong.
Seeing co-captain Ames Akil on the right side of the bench there, just giving a bit of direction to the team. Smiles here on the Windy bench at the moment.
But also you can see Justice Feelgood Marshall there. She hasn't taken his eye off his skater. The rest of the Windy bench, they look pretty confident. Christina Rego moving her legs right now.
And looks like they're going to help her up into a seated position.
She's breathing pretty heavy there. A little slow to start to get up again, but oh, she's there laying her back down again. Doc returning with an ice pack. And they are bringing out actually a wheelchair to get her off the track. And now you can see Windy City's skater is now concerned about their fellow skater, helping her up into the chair. And medical staff here is going to take a look at her, make sure everything's all right.
Windy standing in support of their teammate.
That ice pack on the back of her neck.
Christina Rego apparently leaving the game. If we get an update, we will pass that on to you. Very heavily used blocker by Windy. She's played 24 of their jams in this game, second only to Legal Tenderizer, who has skated in 27 of them. So Christina Rego is going to be a bit of a big loss for them in the pack.
In these waning minutes for Windy City.
Windy does have the lead of 82 points, 197 to 115. Clock stopped at 4:45 remaining on the period clock.
Track staff cleaning up. Where Christina Rago was down.
We should be able to get underway again shortly. Coming up after this at 12 o'clock local time. will be the seventh place game, and that'll be between Helsinki and Queen City. I'll be followed at 5 by No Coast and Boston, and then the medal round kicks off at 4.
Mad Megs for Toronto up at the front of the pack. Jan Trainer getting stopped by that Chevron defense from Toronto. Windy City now having to bridge, and a multiplayer block called on number 62. That's Mako. Mad Megs is your lead jammer for Toronto.
So Mad Megs rocking a 63% lead jammer of this game.
That's the outside and an elbow call on legal tenderizer. 4 points scored by Toronto, bringing them up to 119 with 4 minutes to go.
Toronto is going to have a pack advantage to start this one.
Definite 4-2 pack advantage.
And Mako and Legal Tenderizer, who has now taken her sixth box trip, both in the Derby Supply penalty box. And Rita Hateworthy is going to be on deck, so as soon as a seat frees up, she'll be taking it. Four blockers for Toronto on the floor. Big opportunity here for Lexicon.
Lexicon up against Mia Goham. Mia Goham trying to find that inside track there. Mia Goham having to deal with three blockers in the back, but Lexicon takes it. The advantage of only having two blockers to get past made it pretty easy for Lexicon to do so.
And with all that space,
nice
head fake there against the Jam Burglar.
Little slalom action. 4 points for Lexicon as Rita Hateworthy takes the extra slot in the Derby Supply penalty box.
Mia Culprit going down.
And Mia Goham taking a little spit there. And a low block penalty.
So some Mia on Mia contact results in a box trip for Mia Culprit.
8 point jam for Toronto, bringing them up to 127. It is a 70 point game with 2 minutes, 40 seconds remaining.
Another point found on the floor, so it's actually a 9-0 jam for Toronto. So that's going to cut into that lead just a wee bit. 69 points for Windy City.
2 minutes, 20 seconds to go as the whistle blows. Mad Megs versus Killinois. Killinois cutting through the inside and becomes lead jammer for Windy City. Mad Megs, oh boy, Mad Megs getting knocked around by Windy City as Killinois approaches the back of the pack to begin her scoring pass. Gets tapped to the inside. But a back block. Oh, I'm sorry, but an elbow. And 6 points. And 5 points scored there by Windy City.
Yeah, Rennie Rumble with that elbowing penalty. That is going to be her seventh trip to the Derby Supply penalty box. So she will be done for the day, actually done for the weekend, this being the final game for Toronto. Misery May is going to take her seat in the Derby Supply penalty box to serve that.
As Toronto takes their final team timeout. 1 minute, 27 seconds remaining on the clock. And really, it's with this kind of point differential, Toronto has to know that they're not going to take this. They're going to be going home in 10th place. But they want to finish calm. They want to finish strong. So one final little team talk at the end. Ballerina lining up for Toronto, up against number 4, Jan Trainer, for the Windy City Rollers.
Windy taking the back four wall. Toronto lining up with their three blockers directly in front. Going to run the Chevron, tear apart, going to quarterback that.
And time will begin again.
Ballerina on that fast girl start line and going up against Jan Trainer.
5 seconds is called. And the whistle blows and we are off for possibly the final, maybe two jams. Jan Trainer dealing with a wheelbarrow chevron there. by Toronto.
Mia Culprit taking up a lot of track space here, making things very difficult for Jan Trainer. Nyeka Igwe, though, being sent into the Derby Supply penalty box, and that's going to open up a hole there for Jan Trainer, who takes it, picks up lead jammer for Windy.
And she can just run this clock out if she likes. Gets on through, picks up five big World of Derby points for Windy City. Windy City now at 207. Ballerina has made it through as well. Jan Trainer cuts through. Four more points.
Getting the signal to keep going, run it out. Ballerina is back on and engaging, running into some problems at turn four, but overcomes them.
Oh, Jan Trainer gets a little spin kick into the inside. Ballerina making a move now for some points to finish strong once again. 4 points for Toronto. Five seconds left in the period clock, 36 seconds left in on the jam clock. Ballerina gets two more points. Jan Trainer gets four. And that was a big scoring final jam. 13 for Windy City, 10 for Toronto.
Yeah, both teams hitting double digits.
So we're checking and making sure that all of our I's are dotted and T's are crossed. And that is the final score, 215 to 138 in favor of Windy City. Windy City goes home in ninth place. That is the official final. Toronto goes home in 10th. And that's... I love both these teams.
Yeah.
I love both these teams, and it's unfortunate that they had to play for 9 and 10, but somebody's got to do it. Both of them have had very tough years, a lot of turnover, a lot of injured skaters, a lot of issues, people transferring in, transferring out, a lot of retirements, and they handle it as best they can. Windy City's going home with their heads held high.
Yeah, very, very happy team right now. CM Bauer from Toronto, not feeling too bad themselves. Don't pick up any wins this weekend, but with, again, behind the scenes roster adversity, with injuries, retirements. A month ago, Captain Skarkasm took, you know, a dream job for her, and she's up now in the Arctic Circle. Yep. In Kugluktuk.
She was sending pictures.
Yes.
Of her and her CN Power jersey.
That was a known thing, though. It's not like she just up and left.
Yeah.
Right? These opportunities come along. You have to take them.
And really, even if you end up in 10th place here, you are still one of the best 40 teams in the world because you made it to the D1 playoffs. Mm.
Yeah, and that's nothing to be sneezed at, as
no,
we've been saying.
Not at all.
So result here is that Toronto, yes, does finish in 10th place. Last year in Evansville, they finished in 7th. The year before that, their first appearance at WFTDA playoffs, finishing in 6th in Salem. And Windy City, this will be the first time ever Windy City does not go to championships.
Yeah, that's true.
Last 5 years, yeah, they were there in the quarterfinals, but they come in with the win and go out with a win.
And really, I wouldn't be too surprised if I did not see a bunch of these Windy City skaters in St. Paul. It's a quick drive. They'll be wanting to see what the world holds for them in the next season, because I know Justice Feelgood Marshall, a heck of a coach, and he is going to going to take what he's got and see what he can bring in from outside, see if there's any transfers coming in this year.
See what else they can develop they currently have.
To mold into another team, great team that Windy City, I'm sure Windy City has been on the top, and Windy City will be on the top again. I am certain of that. And Toronto heading back to Canada tonight. But actually, we have Megatron over there with Justice Feelgood Marshall, head coach of the Windy City Rollers. Take it away, Megatron.
Thank you, gentlemen. Now, Justice Feelgood Marshall, you came into today off of two losses. You had a really strong win. What did you say to the team before the game to bring this out?
Really, I focused more on our pride as being Windy City Rollers. As you said, we had a very tough year, and a lot of the losses have been sort of like hard to take. Of course, going in after having two losses in a row here was also not that fun to do. But we talked about how we wanted to go back to Chicago feeling good about, you know, wearing the logo and showing what we could do. And I feel we're confident of much better performances in the last two games, but in this one we actually showed it, and I'm very happy about that.
Now, what is it like as a coach, as a bench manager, as somebody leading the team when you are in a rebuilding season with the loss of so many legacy players from the Windy City Rollers?
Oh, there's no doubt that it was hard, but one of the fortunate things is that we had a pretty solid core on the second win team, so a lot of the players had played together before. The only difference was they hadn't played at the Div 1 level. So in that sense, it wasn't difficult to get people to play together because they had some sort of history there. The problem was a lot this year was that our schedule was based on last year's team, so the games that we played were a little bit above our level to the season. I think, though, that we had a few games through the season. We played a very good half against Atlanta, who was just missed champs 2 weeks ago. And even at ECDX, we did fairly well against Montreal in that first half. So there were flashes of being able to once again compete at the very highest level. And I think this game is the first step in getting back to there, I think.
For sure. And so what's next for you guys? What does 2016 look like?
I don't know. The coaching decision always in the hands of the team, so I don't know whether I'll be around next year or if I will. I am confident, though, that there are enough people in the organization that will definitely keep the legacy moving forward. No doubt about that.
Excellent. Well, congratulations on the awesome win, and I'm looking forward to seeing you at the after party. And it's gonna be a good tournament season. And we've got Helsinki versus Queen City coming up next. Stay tuned. Lots more derby all day today. It's going to be a great final day here at the 2015 International WFTDA Division Tournament in Omaha. I'm Megatron. Thanks a lot for watching. Stay tuned for more.